محمد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهد الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله انتجبه لولايته واختصه برسالته وأكرمه بالنبوة وأشهد أن عليا ولي الله وأمينه في أرضه وحجته على عباده اللهم صل على محمد وآله الطاهرين المعصومين صلوات على محمد وآل محمد اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد أوصيكم عباد الله وإياي بتقوى الله Brothers and sisters, my oldest, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته First, remind myself and I urge all of my brothers and sisters towards the taqwa of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and obedience towards Him. We are approaching the end of the month of Ramadan, and this is the last Friday of the month of Ramadan. And during this holy month of Ramadan, we have been the guests of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this setting where He is our host and we are His guests, that will end soon. We pray that He accepts our fasts and our a'mal, He accepts our hajat and our istighfar during this holy month. He is a gracious host, so we pray that He forgives our trespasses and our mistakes, and He forgives our sins that we have committed during this month and before, and may He accept our repentance, our sincere repentance. Jabir ibn Abdullah, Rizwanullahi alayhi wa rahmatuh, narrated from the Holy Prophet of Islam, Muhammad al-Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, that one should recite the following dua on the last Friday of the holy month of Ramadan, as well as on the last day of the month of Ramadan. And this dua, the Holy Prophet, he, after teaching this to Jabir, he says that whoever recites this dua, and clearly with the earnestness and serious sincerity and meaning this dua from the heart, he will receive one of two benefits. Either he will live until the next month of Ramadan, Allah will give us this gift again, or we will obtain the mercy and forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this dua is, if you will recite with me, raise your hands. Allahumma salli ala Muhammadin wa ala Muhammad. Allahumma taja'alahu akhir al-ahdi min siyamina iyyah. Fa'in ja'altahu faja'alni marhuma wa la taja'alni mahruma. May Allah not make this the last month of Ramadan that in which we are fasting. May He give us another year of the month of Ramadan. But if it is that we will pass on to the hereafter before the coming of the next month of Ramadan, may He give us this month full of mercy and forgiveness, and don't make us mahroom and shortcoming of for those mercies and bounties of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Rabbana taqabbal minna innaka anta sami'ud du'a. The holy month of Ramadan, at the end of the holy month of Ramadan, is a time for self-assessment and reflection of what we have achieved during this holy month of Ramadan. And we still have a few hours, a day or so, that to obtain. So this is the last opportunity for us to obtain what is left for us to obtain from the bounties of this month and from the mercies of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But Friday is also a day to remember our deceased relatives, our parents, our grandparents, our uncles and aunts, our brothers and sisters who are no longer with us, for they rely on us now. Their book of deeds are closed, and it is our duty to remember them on these days, on the Fridays, as well as on the days of Eid. We say after every prayer in the month of Ramadan, Allahumma adkhil ala ahli al-qubur al-surur. O Allah, enter the light of joy and happiness into the graves of the mu'mineen. But we can also make our deceased relatives joyful and happy by visiting them. And if we cannot visit them, we can also give them gifts, small gifts through sadaqah on their behalf. Recite a short prayer of two raka'at for on their behalf, for their thawab. And this will give that light to them, that solace and that serenity in their graves. And us visiting them as well, they know when we visit them, and they realize that their surviving offspring are visiting them, and they feel happiness and joy from that. And when we leave, they feel a sense of loneliness. So we should continually visit them and at least send these small tokens of thawab for them and for their isal thawab. Secondly, Friday is also the day in which the Imam of our time, Imam al-Asr, al-Hujjat ibn al-Hassan, ajalallahu ta'ala farajahu al-Sharif, he will reappear. And may Allah hasten his reappearance. So let this Friday be a day in which we renew our pledge to him. And as we give our solemn pledge to be true Shias and followers of the Imams, alayhim as-salatu was-salam, and this as well as Eid, when we are thinking about giving gifts to each other, let us not forget our Imam, the Imam of our time, when we are giving gifts to each other and to our brothers and sisters and to our children. Let us give small tokens to our Imam as well through giving sadaqah on his behalf and through prayers and other gestures of ibadat. Because he doesn't need this from us, but it is our token of our love and affection and our commitment to him and as our pledge to him. And finally, Friday and Eid are also the days in which we give our gifts to our children and we're buying our gifts, we should also remember those who are less fortunate than us around the world. There are families who are at this very time and in the past, they have been subjected to oppression, poverty, and all manners of tribulations. And it is our responsibility to remember them, those of us who are well off and are living in a life of luxury in these parts of the world. Think of the orphans and the widows of Syria and Iraq and Yemen. Think of those persecuted, tortured, and killed in Bahrain in Saudi Arabia. Let's not forget the recent tragedy in Kuwait. May Allah give them all sabr and forbearance during these times. Think of those people who are displaced in Burma, in Yemen, in Palestine. Think of those families destroyed due to sectarian assassinations and killings in Pakistan, in Iraq, in other parts of the world. Think of those who are widowed and orphaned. Think of those who have been occupied and imprisoned in refugee camps by occupying regimes such as Israel. July marks the anniversary of two things to my knowledge at this time. It was just a year ago in July, when the Palestinians of the Gaza Strip were bombarded for more than 50 days or so, and more than 2,000 Palestinians were killed. 17,000 were injured. Imagine how many of them were children who were orphaned and widows, how many children were killed. 500,000 were displaced within the Gaza Strip. It was also 20 years ago in July when 8,000 Bosnian men and boys were massacred in Srebrenica by the Serbian armed forces. Many towns were pillaged and women were violated. This was on the doorsteps of Europe. And while the world looked on, the Muslims were oppressed in such a manner not seen since the time of the Second World War. And the list of tragedies go on. And the basic truth of these tragedies and the massacres is that they are either perpetrated by the offshoots of the theology of the Banu Sa'ud, or by Western powers on the beck and call of the government of Israel, if not the government of Israel themselves directly perpetrating these crimes. This is a fact that we have to realize and not ignore. We live in these lands where Saudi Arabia and Israel are seen as our friends, our political friends. But let's not forget that they are our enemies, despite any diplomatic relationships that our governments may have with them. It is these two enemies, the governments of Saudi Arabia and Israel, who still act on the path of Muawiyah, being the greatest perpetrators of injustice in these times, and the massacre of Muslims and oppression against the Muslims, while they deflect the blame onto others. This was the political playbook of Muawiyah. When he was told that Ammar ibn Yasir alayhi rahma was martyred in the Battle of Siffin, how did he deflect the blame? We all know. He said it was Amir al-Mu'mineen alayhi salam, through bringing him to battle. He was the killer of Muawiyah, killer of Ammar ibn Yasir. May Allah curse such enemies of Islam who, through their trickery, they make fools of the world. But we need to be aware and cognizant of these facts. So let us stand in solidarity with our brothers and sisters in faith in their times of need, and let us remember them. And when we buy gifts this Eid, also spare something for those widows and orphans around the world, apart from the obligatory fitrah and the obligatory fidyas that we may be liable for. Let's spare a bit, some extra change for those widows and orphans who desperately need our help. نسأل الله الذي جمعنا لهذا الجمع أن يباركنا في يومنا هذا وأن يرحمنا جميعا إنه على كل شيء قدير. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. قل هو الله أحد الله الصمد لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله الذي لا مضاد له في ملكه ولا منازع له في أمره الحمد لله الذي لا شريك له في خلقه ولا شبيه له في عظمته نشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله جاء اللهم صل على محمد وعلى محمد جاء من عنده مصدقا للمرسلين وخلف فينا رأية الحق عليا وأولاده المعصومين حجج الله إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على محمد وعلى محمد اللهم صل على عبدك ورسولك سيد المرسلين ورسول رب العالمين محمد المصطفى اللهم صل على محمد وعلى محمد وعلى أمير المؤمنين ووصي رسول رب العالمين علي المرتضى اللهم صل على محمد وعلى محمد وعلى سيدة نساء العالمين وبضعة خاتم النبيين فاطمة الزهراء اللهم صل على محمد وعلى محمد وعلى سيد الشباب أهل الجنة الحسن المجتبى والحسين سيد الشهداء اللهم صل على محمد وعلى محمد وعلى علي بن الحسين ومحمد بن علي وجعفر بن محمد وموسى بن جعفر وعلي بن موسى ومحمد بن علي وعلي بن محمد والحسن بن علي والحجة بن الحسن القائم المنتظر المهدي اللهم صل على محمد وعلى محمد أرواحنا وأرواح العالمين له الفداء اللهم افتح له فتحا يسيرا وانصره نصرا عزيزا اللهم إنا نرغب إليك في دولة كريمة تعز بها الإسلام وأهله وتظل بها النفاق وأهله وتجعلنا فيها من الدعاة إلى طاعتك والقادة إلى سبيلك وترزقنا بها كرامة الدنيا والآخرة اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد الله سبحانه وتعالى has said in the Holy Quran وَإِنْ جَنَحُوا لِلسَّلْمِ فَاجْنَحْ لَهَا وَتَوَكَّلْ عَلَى اللَّهِ إِنَّهُ هُوَ السَّمِيعُ الْعَلِيمُ وَإِنْ يُرِيدُوا أَنْ يَخْدَعُوكَ فَإِنَّ حَسْبَكَ اللَّهُ وَهُوَ الَّذِي أَيَّدَكَ بِنَصْرِهِ وَبِالْمُؤْمِنِينَ صَدَقَ اللَّهُ الْعَلِيُّ الْعَظِيمُ In this verse, salawat ala Muhammad wa ala Muhammad. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala Muhammad. In this verse, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us instructions that if they, the enemies of the Holy Prophet, the enemies of Islam, incline to peace, then you also incline to it and trust in Allah. Surely He is the all-hearing, the all-knowing. And if they intend to deceive you, if it is their intention from the very beginning, or it becomes their intention to deceive you, then surely Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is sufficient for us. Hasbunallah. It is He who will strengthen us with His help, and His help through the mu'mineen. Through ourselves, Allah will help Islam. On Tuesday, the Islamic Republic of Iran reached a historic deal with the USA and other Western powers. And it is a deal which will be beneficial for all, and especially the mu'mineen of Iran, who have undergone difficult times during the sanctions imposed upon them by the enemies of Islam. And Allah has said in this verse that if the enemies are inclined to peace, then it is not of our benefit to continue warring with them. Let us negotiate a certain peace agreement. But if our intention is sincere, but if their intention is insincere, then Allah suffices for us. Allah is our helper. We do our part of the agreement, and they are obliged to do their part of the agreement. But if they deceive us, if they cheat us, if they violate this agreement, then we need not worry. Allah will help us. The point of such deals is to do itmam al-hujjah, that before the world, we are not seen as those who want war for the sake of war. We do not thrive on war as some terrorists do, as some governments do. We would prefer peace. And the religion of Islam has always been the religion of peace. But if need be, if the enemies of Islam attack us, we also know how to battle and how to war, because we are the followers of Sayyid al-Shuhada, Abu Abdullah al-Husayn alayhi salam. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ali Muhammad, and the followers of Abu Muhammad al-Hasan al-Mujtaba alayhi salam. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ali Muhammad. If they want peace, Imam Hassan alayhi salam has taught us how to do peace. And Imam Hussein alayhi salam taught us that if peace is no longer an option and if they violate their part of the agreement, then we know how to die as martyrs. So we should not fear Allah subhanahu, we should not fear them, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will help us, and He will help Islam through us. This is what He says in the Quran. That Allah will help the Prophet and the Muslims directly, yansuruhu wa bil mu'mineen, and He will help us through the mu'mineen, through the power that the mu'mineen have. And we congratulate Iran on being in these negotiations an equal force among the parties involved, as they negotiated with integrity and self-confidence on a platform of political equality, not as a party who has no self-worth before the Western imperialist rulers, like we find many of the Muslim states. Indeed, it seems that the only Muslim country to stand face to face against these worldly powers is Iran. While other Muslim rulers, they seem to be always kneeling before them, kneeling before their masters. And as the American counterparts themselves said, it is not an agreement based on trust, it's based on verification. So just as they will be verifying through inspections Iran's part of the deal, we as Muslims, as supporters of our fellow brothers and sisters in Iran, need to also verify wherever we are. We may not be citizens of Iran, but we are their brothers and sisters in faith, and we should act on their behalf as well to verify and to ensure that the other parties of the agreement also uphold their part of the agreement. And if it is their intention to violate this and to stall time or anything else, then alhamdulillah, we've done our part, and we will not bow down to them, and we will have a strength which they don't have, and that is the love of Ahlul Bayt alayhim salatu wassalam, and obedience towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that commitment to Islam which they fear. This is what they fear about the Muslims the most: how committed we are, how we pray 5 times a day, how we fast. Due to this, the enemies of Islam tremble. And also, this deal is a strike against the enemies of Islam, who are now extremely vexed. Saudi Arabia and Israel, they are now in full fear-mongering mode, where they are speaking against this agreement as if it's the beginning of the apocalypse. And they are deceiving the people around us. And it is our duty, living in these parts of the world, to inform the people around us who we work with and who we study with and our neighbors. If they ask us about the situation, we should tell them the reality. And we can only tell them of the reality of this agreement if we first know about this agreement and we know about the points and what was agreed upon. But nevertheless, this is a strike against those enemies, those enemies of Islam. And this in itself shows that this was the right thing to do. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the strength to stand up against the enemies of Islam and to remain committed to peace in the seerah of Imam Hassan alayhi salam and the seerah of the Imam alayhi salatu wa salam. May Allah give us further strength in remaining committed to Islam in obedience towards Allah and the Quran and the Ahlul Bayt alayhim salatu wa salam. May Allah accept our amal during this holy month of Ramadan, accept our hajat, and may He give us this gift again of us being His guests and Him being our host, and for us to feast again in this sufra of nourishment for the soul. Allahumma تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم اللهم اغفر للمؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات الأحياء منهم والأموات اللهم تابع بيننا وبينهم بالخيرات إنك مجيب الدعوات إنك على كل شيء قدير وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله على محمد وآله الطاهرين المعصومين الله.
Mu'mineen, there are many people waiting at the back. Please kindly stand up from now before the Iqamah starts. Please fill in any